हेलो दोस्तों, केजी क्लासेस में आपका स्वागत है। आज हम लाइफ एंड वर्क ऑफ जनरल मैनली हॉपकिंस के बारे में अध्ययन करेंगे। जीएम हॉपकिंस वाज बोर्न इन 1844, ही डाइड इन 1889। ही इज ए मैचलेस केस इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। सो लॉन्ग एज ही वाज अलाइव, नथिंग ऑफ व्हाट ही रोट वाज पब्लिश्ड। His famous poems were first published in 1918. During these 29 years, he was almost in obscurity. Immediately after the publication of the first collection of his poems, he came into prominence. His influence was greatly felt. His effect upon the poets of the younger generation was so great and widespread that the aspect of modern poetry was changed. His effect continued for a long time and is still unexhausted. Hopkins was educated at Highgate School. Therefrom he went to Valliard College, Oxford. There he became a follower of the Anglican High Church Party. In 1866, he began Roman Catholic. After 2 years, he joined the Society of Jesus. For a while, he discontinued writing poetry under certain religious compulsions. There was a shipwreck in December 1875 in which 5 Franciscan nuns were drowned. Hopkins not inspiration to write a poem, The Wreck of the Deutschland. Hopkins was highly religious. He was also a great scholar. He served as a professor of Greek at Dublin University. Hopkins loved nature. He has to his credit some of the good nature poems in the English language, but he was much different from the romantic poets, both in his opinion towards nature and in his treatment of nature. He left from the romantic style of poetry. In his poetry we find some sort of revival of John Donne. He adopted metrical forms and a verse technique which owed something to Donne and other metaphysical poets. However, he was far more an innovator than a borrower. He described his own system of prosody in the term sprung rhythm. He used the word inscape to denote his aim in the treatment of the subject of his poems. Hopkins is regarded as a difficult writer to understand even by his admirer and disciples. At the same time, he is considered as one of the greatest English poet. Hopkins was much ahead of his time. It is argued that had he published his poems during his lifetime, he might not have been accepted favorably. The Victorian age was mainly the age of the show. Bell published The Age of Victorian Compromise of Order, Decency, Sense of Respectability in Social Life. It was at variance with his own temperament and outlook. The climate was not favorable to intellectual complexity and spiritual probing of his type. It was after his death that the last decade of the 19th century, known in the death that the last de- known in the literary jargon as the naughty 90s or the period of decadence, that the writers revolt against the Victorianism and against all those values which were so fervently cherished during the naughty 90s and during the Edwardian and early Georgian period, much had changed. The First World War brought about abruptly a great change in every walk of life. Old values were broken during the war. The atrocities perpetrated by the marching armies would moved the very foundation of the age-long faith in religion, ethical and moral values, and even in the inherent goodness in man's nature. People had begun to question the essentiality and efficacy of Christian observance. A spirit of inquiry crossed the borders of cynicism. It was in a changed atmosphere that Hopkins' poems were first published. Hopkins brought forth realism in English poetry. His influence on the writers of leisure genius was most valued. They imitated his style without quite clearly understanding and controlling his language. They therefore made poetry obscure, difficult to understand. This made poetry less popular than fiction. Nevertheless, he found some good imitators who were great poets and who made commendable efforts to continue the Hopkins tradition. As such, it would not be an exaggeration to say that modern poetry begins with Hopkins. He is very often compared with T.S. Eliot. Critics find close similarity between Hopkins' cult and Eliot's cult. His main work, Spring, God's Grandeur, The Caged Skylark, Felix Rendell, Pied Beauty, In Verse Ned, Harry Plowman, The Wreck of the Dutch Lana, Deutschland, Dutchland, The Windhover, Spell from Sibyl's Leaves, That Nature, Hereditian Fire. Thanks.